Hello everyone, welcome back to Sun Innovative YouTube channel, and we are back with a new video on soft starter and importance on use inductive load. So let's start this video. First, starting with what is soft starter and what is the need of this. When the power supply is connected with a use inductor like a induction motor or use inductive load, then as you know, the motor equivalent circuit and it's an inductor load. So according to the working of it, it will produce the induced current at the starting of induction motor, and after that it will be settled down to the healthy condition or the rated current. As you can see in diagram, induced current is starting. As the starting, it will be going to increase, and at that time voltage is going to reduce it. So this induced current is associated with the different problems like high power consumption, winding loss and the damage of insulation, reduction in efficiency and reduction in a life cycle. So you can see in diagram also that how this induced current is going to affect it to the motor windings and the efficiency of the material also. So now let's talk about the solution of this problem. So it can be controlled by using the soft starter and the using of AVC. It is a AC voltage controller, and you can see in the diagram there are the thyristors are used in a soft starter. The input voltage can be controlled by firing angle alpha, and as we know that initial time due to the induced current, the firing angle must be set to the high values, because we need to reduce the RMS voltage for the few initial cycles. And after it gets settled down of the induced current and the effect of the induced current, so that time and the inductor windings got charged in a previous 2-3 cycle. So we need to slow down the firing angle. It means we need to reduce the firing angle so that we can increase the RMS values, and so that we can control the induced current at the few cycles which is generated the induced current at the initial time. So that can be happen, or it can be controlled with the AVC. Now you can see the effect of soft starter and the without the soft starter induced current. The diagram is shown there. So to doing this, we need to refer the diagram to create the soft starter. So basically this is the closed loop system in which many circuits like zero crossing detector and firing delay and the pulse generation with the synchronized with the source, and to achieve the low induced current at the starting of induction motor, we need to do the closed loop simulation. So let us start the simulation of this project, and we will see the result also. So let's starting. Okay, now this is the simulation of a soft starter of three-phase inductive load, and the all our component I found from the Simulink library as usual, and let me show you the library here. So this is the path of the all component which I have taken for this simulation. So you can go to the simscape, and in which you can go to the power system and the fundamental blocks and the electrical source. So you can get this all the elements, sources and the machine and the power electronic switches. So all the component is available here. So it is I don't think it is very hard to find the each component, but if you don't find, please write in a comment, I will give you the name of the block. Now see, this is the power supply of three phase, and this is the measurement block is here, and these three thyristors are connected here, and see, this is the anti-parallel connection. So let me show you the subsystem. For the simplicity, I have created the subsystem here. So see here, this one is the first block of the phase A. This thyristor T1 and T2 is connected anti-parallel with each other, and these two terminals of these two anti-parallel thyristors is here, and the gate is common with the two thyristors, so that pulses will be given to the two same thyristors. And the same way the T2, this block is also having the same construction and the connection, and the T3 also is having the same construction and connection. Now this again, the voltmeter is connected here to observe the output voltage after controlling the voltage by using these thyristors, and this is the load resistance is connected here to get the output voltage, and the inductive load is connected. So here the two different load is we have taken here, one is resistive load and one is inductive load. So we need to check the individual performance of this, and here I have arranged for the output parameters of inductive load, and this is the five blocks are here. First one is a three phase zero crossing detector, because we need to synchronize the pulse, so that's why I have created here zero crossing detector using the gain and demux and the absolutes. And after three phase two individual signals is coming to the pulse generator, and this is the relation operator to create the zero crossing detector. It means it will give the pulse at zero values, so don't worry about it, I will show you the results also. So this one is a synchronous pulse delay, because we need to also provide the delay at various firing angle alpha, so I have used the transport delay here. And the whatever the pulses is generated from IG1, 2 and 3, that will be given to these three thyristors. You can see the name is same, IG1, IG1, IG2, IG2 and IG3, IG3. And these two bottom blocks are to provide the firing angle delay. And this is the main block of the simulation, because we want that at initial time 0.2 second or 0.1 second we need to provide the time interval. So in between that time the firing angle was different, and after the healthy condition the firing angle must be changed, because once the inrush current pass away or the over period of the healthy condition, so that time the firing angle adjusted to zero values, because we need a full cycle for the full powering to the motor. And the initial stage we need a 90% of the RMS current, because initial time the inrush current was very high, so that time we need to adjust the firing angle according to the 90 degree, so that can be also adjusted to this block. And I will open it and I will show you that. Okay, so let me show you this one. So this is the step parameter here, so you can see I have set for the 0.2 values. It means it will be going to work with the 0.2 values. Initial I have set for the 0.9 and 2. So this is the condition values. It means after the 0.2 it will be different firing angle for this block, and the before that time the firing angle will be 90 degree. So that I have created for this one, and these are the scopes are here. So let me run this simulation. So before, I would like to show you that how the converter is going to work. So for that I need to remove this signal here, because I want that the converter, how it's going to operate it. So for that I will do that one thing, I will directly connect it without this program, and let me connect this transport delay to this signal directly bypassing this one, because I don't want to connect right now. And one more thing I want to comment out this motor, and let me show you the how only the AVC automatic voltage or AC voltage controller is going to work. So let me comment out and try to run this simulation. So let me do one thing here, infinite, so I can show you the continuous change of this. So I'm running this simulation here. So let me first open the gate pulse. So this one is a input voltage, and the bottom you can see this is the reference current, reference voltage, and the PWM pulse is generated. So orange line, this one is the original pulse and this is the shifted pulse. So let me also show you that how to give the different firing angle for this one. So let me use the slider gain here. So you can see the blue lines will be going to shifted according to my firing angle. You can see these things. So you can see in your window that how the blue lines is going to shifted. See this. This one is a difference of firing angle. So now I will going to use this technique to develop the firing angle with the different values and getting the output voltage. So this effect also you can see in output voltage also here. So I have taken for the single phase, so you can see this one. And let me check my converter. So again I'm opening my slider again, and let me show you the effect of firing angle. See, you can see the RMS value is reduces using this slider gain. And as I'm reducing the firing angle, so full RMS I can going to consider. See this one. So this is all about the performance of the AC voltage controller. and I'm using the firing angle, right? So now I'm using this concept and I'm going to try to connect my old circuit which I have made for the actually the soft starter. So that I'm going to connect here. So let me remove this connection, and again I'm connecting here this all parameters, and let me remove this comment, uncomment, and I'm now connecting this motor to the load and try to run this simulation so I can give you the best result as I have taken for. So let me change these values to the 768. So without this one, so you can see if I'm running this simulation. Okay, let me stop because I have created for the infinite time. So let me do the 0.3 here. Okay, now this is the result. You can see this is the input voltage and this is the load current. So you can see that initially the current is set up to the 50 amperes and it will be going to settle down after this effect. So this is the effect of the automatic voltage controller soft starter, because if you don't use this one, so that will be going to very huge current, like 100 amperes or more than 100 amperes. So for that I will also show you that how it is going to do. So again I am going to remove this connection, so you will be understand that how if I am removing or if I am directly connecting to this system without this block, so how the inrush current is going to behave into the system. So let me run this. So before it was the below 80 ampere, and now we are going to check the results for this one. And you can see this is the inrush current here, and it is too huge inrush current. So this is a problem of our system. So this area we need to remove from the system so that this inrush current can be controlled. So that we are using this system for the initial period. So let me connect this one again. And I'm trying to get the results. And I wanted to reduce that portion at initial system which was created in last case study. So let me run this simulation and I'll show you this. Okay, now I'm stopping the simulation. So you see here, this one is limited for the 15 amperes because it was previously 80 amperes, you can see. And you can compare the results and you can pause these videos and you can go to the reverse timings of these videos and you can compare the both results, that it is limited to the 50 amperes and the previous case was limited to the 80 amperes. So that portion is going to remove, and this is the variable actually you can set according to their load conditions and depend on the timing of inrush current, so that can be also adjustable. So this was the only case studies for three phase inductive load with a soft starter. So this is my point and this is the simulation. So hope you guys do like this video and like the simulation. Thank you guys, thank you very much.